Hello, I am Dr. Harilaos Koumaras from NCSR Demokritos, and on behalf of all the authors of this paper, I'm going to present you the paper entitled NEFSim, an open experimentation framework utilizing 3GPP's exposure service. The structure and the contents of the paper includes the introduction, a brief presentation of the 3GPP NEF services. Then we are going to talk about the NEFSim architecture, then about the implementation aspects, and finally about the conclusions and future work. First of all, about the introduction, it's necessary to mention about the 5G programmability, the new feature that the 5G core offers through its openness, and promises a new generation of applications which will deliver an unprecedented user experience. The 3GPP in 5G has decided to expose some features of the core network through some standardized native APIs, like for example the NEF function, the network exposure function. And the service-based architecture of the core network enables this internal communication between the core functions through APIs, but also initiates this communication through the APIs with external entities as well, allowing a bi-directional communication between the vertical applications and the core network, the 5G core network, on top of which they are running. A special function in order to enable this 5G programmability is the 3GPP NEF function, Network Exposure Function. In this paper, we provide the classification of the various NEF services as they are defined in 3GPP TS 29.522 document. So we are talking about the monitoring services, the location services, the policy charging services, the analytics services, the IoT, as well as the application provisioning services, which are all of them exposed through the native APIs of the NEF function. Here you can have a more closer look to the respective APIs, the different categories that these APIs belong to, as well as a small service description of what type of information and data these APIs are exposing. Here you can see the REST categories, and you can see that 3GPP has a very wide collection of APIs from different categories and services in order to support a great variety of vertical applications and services. Now, due to the fact that currently there is not available any 5G system that actually exposes, implements this NEF service and exposes to third parties these NEF services, in order to facilitate testing and validation in the framework of research activities, in this paper we are presenting our NEF simulator, which is actually a simulator that provides to the user the option to test and interact with the NEF services based on different simulated environments. As you can see, the architecture of the NEF simulator includes a simulation environment where there is a dashboard, a geographic representation map, where the user can define its location, its status, if it is static or a moving user, and also to define different scenarios and events. For example, different antennas, the number of the cells, the coverage of each cell, and etc. And also we have some intelligence in this NEF simulator, where we have the network social function implementation, with a common management layer where we have the authentication and authorization of the user, as well as the exposure layer. We have the monitoring event API and also the sessions with QoS API that we expose through the southbound interface. So currently, our NEF simulator implements these two APIs from the NEF services, the monitoring and the QoS. And through this exposure, first of all, we provide also to the user of the NEF sim all the potential interaction that these APIs support. In order to do this, we have the fast API use as a component for the development of the APIs based on the Open API standard. We have a Swagger for the user interface and the doc. We have a PostgreSQL and MongoDB in order to store all the necessary information for the administration and monitoring. Then we have the graphical user interface with the dashboard and the map. And we have a configurable environment with the 5G cells, the base station of Xenobis, the different UE categories based on the movement speed, and also have some predefined paths that enable the UAE movement. Finally, the whole deployment of the NEFSim is based on container. The whole solution is containerized. For all of you that you may be interested in testing the NEF simulator, here is the GitHub link where we have released the latest stable version of this open source project. And I invite you all to download the test, the NEF simulator. Here is the management dashboard where you can see that you have an overview of the simulation that is currently running, the number of the cells, the UEs, and etc. Here is the graphical user interface where we have set up different number of cells, the coverage of the cells, as well as the moving UEs that formulate the specific scenario. Let's discuss now about how the NEFSim can support a vertical application through an example of the session with QoS API. For example, generally speaking, you know that the applications request QoS information from the network in order to adapt accordingly their status for optimizing their performance. The applications in this case can request QoS from a set of standardized values, for example, 5QI. Depending on the results, the notifications that they receive, they will adapt accordingly the application behavior. Usually the scope is the QoS optimization. In order to receive notifications from the NEF, the 5QI needs to be a GPR value. So the notification can be either periodic, for example every 2 seconds, or based on an event triggering. The event that triggers the notification occurs, for example, on handover. So if the UE chooses a GPR, for example, and enters a cell that another UE is already connected, then the QoS cannot be guaranteed. And this will report back the QoS not guaranteed value by the NEF. Here we can see, running, for example, this scenario, how the NEF sim reports back the proper event QoS not guaranteed. Of course, we can demonstrate also many other scenario and to show how the NEF emulator can be used in order to assist any application developer to make a 5G aware application which uses the different APIs from the core network in order to raise the awareness of the application to the network conditions and the underlying 5G system. So, concluding, the NEFSim is a configurable simulated environment which realizes the 3GPP northbound NEF APIs. We have presented the architecture and implementation aspects, and we have discussed about the different NEF services classifications. The NEFSim is an open source simulator, and we have the whole source code available at our GitHub page, which can be visited in order to download the NEFSim, to test it and let us know any feedback is valuable for us. Now, the future work is about the implementation of additional NEFAPIs. For example, the loss of connectivity event is an event that we are working now on it, as well the integration of NEF with some commonly used frameworks like the Open5GS. Other aspects also that we are considering as future work is the NWDAF about receiving information about the network conditions and etc. It is important, however, to mention that all this work is acknowledged to the 5GPP Evolved 5G project, which is an ICT41 project that deals with the NetApps and the development of vertical enabled applications. Thank you very much. I am Dr. Harilaos Koumaras, and also this work has been supported by Dimitrios Fragkos, my PhD candidate. So any questions that you have, please don't hesitate to directly contact us by sending an email to us. Thank you very much for your attention.